What shall we do? Oh, look. Foggy's found some bird droppings. He put that to a nicer fella.
Shut up.
Where is it?
Well, right now, it's oozing between the second and third fingers of my right hand.
Why don't you promise me, Foggy, when we get to the cap this morning, you'll let somebody else pass the buns.
That looks like a wood pigeon's.
Damn, we'll have to do it right when I put my hand.
But I'm wiping down my jacket.
Maybe it just looked like he was wiping it on your jacket. It's an impression you can easily get when somebody's...
There he goes again.
Wiping his hand down your jacket.
How far is it to the ground?
About 18 inches.
God, I'll never make it.
Well, I've heard of no head for heights, but you've got no legs, arms or eyes for it.
I like it on the ground. I really like being here on the ground.
Oh, look at me, jacket.
What are you griping about?
Just look at me, jacket.
Precisely, just look at it. I've never seen anything that nature intended more for wiping bird droppings on than that.
What's it pulling up face for? Well, that won't turn them.
No? I noticed the pigeons soon got rid of it.
It's the only thing that worries me about going to heaven. Would I ever get used to the height?
Sid from the calf.
What, sneaking about with a bedroll?
Well, anything's an improvement on his sausage rolls.
Sid, he's up to no good. Oh, the lucky beggar.
Let's not jump to conclusions. There's probably some perfectly reasonable explanation.
He's having it off with a bird.
Well, then, I told you there'd be some reasonable explanation.
Let's not start spreading gossip. I mean, I don't approve of this sort of thing when its secret is safe with us. We're not women to be tittle-tattling about this sort of scandalous thing. It'll be that big dozy bus conductor's orders.
I must say, in circumstances like these, my suspicions tend spontaneously towards her behind the bacon counter at the corner.
It's just like Sid. He's never happy unless he's getting his divvy.
Like a stamp collector with a penny black. Just dying to lick her and stick it in his album.
He wants to watch her. She hit me once with a ticket machine.
Only because she hadn't got anything heavier.
Passive.
I don't know if she starts asking questions. We'll be very careful here not to drop him in it.
Wouldn't it be rotten to drop him in it?
Unthinkable.
Hey, I wonder if he can take the joke.
Three teas?
Yeah, and three of your delicious buns, please.
What are you looking at me for? You're up to something, aren't you? Look at me when I'm talking to you!
Hey, God, the mind of a just got painted because he was looking at me.
What's going on?
Well, I'm trying to rub some feeling back where I was struck with a spoon, and he's busy suppressing a scream of agony.
My compliments, madam, on your skill with a spoon.
You are acting very shifty.
Shifty?
Us? Never.
Who's going to pay?
Yes.
Come on, whose turn is it?
Yes.
Is three teas, please, Ivy, and three buns, is it?
42p.
Thank you. he dare go messing about with other women. She'll kill him.
A man has to do what a man has to do.
Lecherous husband murdered with spoon. Where's your bun?
He's eating it.
Already?
It went like a ball down a drain.
Make it easier, Bunch. And somebody else must be dead easy when she goes to meet a bloke in broad daylight carrying a bedroll. There's confidence for you. A bedroll. But all I ever had all my life was a very large handkerchief.
Have a bun.
Never mind. Have a bun. What's this about a bedroll?
Tasty, Ivy. How do you keep that complexion? Oh, not the spoon, Ivy. Not the spoon.
Who have you seen with a bedding roll? And where was he, the swine?
Who have we seen with a bedding roll? Maybe we caught a glimpse.
Yeah, just the faintest movement in the trees.
Trees? What the devil was he doing in the trees?
When I say trees, I don't mean trees. I mean, what's he going to do with that spoon?
It could have been anybody.
Anybody?
Just this figure flitting away.
Hello, we said. There goes anybody.
It was him, wasn't it? My own husband, heading for the trees with a bedding roll, which he swore he'd only use for approved recreational purposes.
It was undoubtedly just what he was doing.
I know what he was doing.
He is your husband, Ivy. You ought to trust him more.
Oh, give me one good reason.
Time to think about that. I mean,
it's just the call of the wide open spaces, Ivy. Men have this thing.
I know. It's what they're always trying to do with it that irritates me.
Proceed.
No, not there. Never.
You just sit there and lie.
Naturally. He's our mate.
You can't trust him.
Well, you can, Ivy, if you look on the bright side.
Bright side? What bright side?
Well, you've got one great natural advantage, which should give you confidence. Sin is basically, when you get right down to it, fundamentally, a genuine, horrible-looking mess.
That is quite true.
I mean, who's going to want him?
His ears are too big.
And what about that haircut? What idiot cuts it like that?
I do.
Oh, it's beautifully styled.
He's got no personality, you see, not an ounce of charm.
So there you are, you see, Ivy. Count your blessings.
It's true. The fool. He'd be hopeless as a hippie. He's not cut out for it. He goes all to pieces if he doesn't get good gravy.
What's this about a hippie? Who said he wants to be a hippie?
Not seen.
Never.
Oh, I've seen the restlessness coming over him. I've tried to talk him out of it. I keep hitting him.
Is he telling you he wants to be a hippie?
Oh, no, no. He never tells me anything. He just goes about sneakily. He's at that dangerous age.
Dangerous.
Because I'm going to kill him.
Sid would never want to be a hippie.
Then why would he take a bedding roll? Why does he keep sneaking out into the countryside?
There's some perfectly ordinary explanation.
Like what?
He's chasing some bird.
Very tactful of him. Just cheered her up a treat, doesn't
it? Yes, well, I thought it was better than letting her know he was going to be a hit.
No, it isn't. If he were going out collecting wildflowers or picking mushrooms, that might be better than yippee, yippee.
Yeah, well, it's funny you should say that, Ivy, because we were only thinking this morning in the trees, weren't we? We said, hello, there goes Sid with his bedding roll, off to collect some wildflowers or maybe pick some mushrooms.
Please don't cry, you've still got me. Come on, I will give you a little solace.
Well, he has his uses, you see. His old training beginning to pay off. He's developing a few manners. See, when I first took him in hand, he was no more than an uncouth little scruff. But with the right tuition, he's becoming quite a coarse little scruff.
Trying to cheer her up by showing that she's still attractive to me.
Did she hit you with?
I don't know, but it was worth it.
Oh, I'm going to turn out of here.
Tino, I think.
think Ivy is extremely handy on the spoon.
Aye. Old Sid must be bruised all over.
Yeah, when you keep colliding with Ivy like that, it must be a bit like being knocked down by a tram.
It is. Oh, but it's lovely.
Yeah, I can't imagine anyone volunteering to tango with Ivy.
Has got no soul. He hasn't got any romance in his body at all.
Ah, but he has got a knife with attachments for opening cans.
Romance, I think it's disgusting, a chap your age.
Well, just because I happen to have passed the first flush of you. A man is as old as he feels.
How old do you feel?
As old as they'll let me. Oh, that Ivy, she's a powerful lass. Still, after a couple of more pints, I'll be fighting fit.
Do you think you could settle for just one more pint and being sort of moderately fit?
Oh, very well, Norm, if you insist. Has they ever been in love, Foggy?
Mind your own business.
That's not to be ashamed of.
I'm not ashamed. I just don't wish to discuss my personal affairs in this cheap drinking establishment.
Cheap? You wait till you go up to buy your own. I wonder if Clegg's ever been in love.
Well, he was married, wasn't he?
Oh, aye. Well, that's always a major snack to your love life. What sort of birds do you like, Foggy?
Look, are you absolutely sure you'll want another round after this?
Really is a cheapskate.
Well, you don't really mean it. You know, you've had enough excitement for one morning.
Excitement? What are you talking about? My nerves are as steady as a rock.
You're shaking like a leaf.
Oh, yes, but then he is leading a life of sin and dissipation.
Only since I left school. No. When your missus were alive, did you ever go off pussyfooting it with another woman?
Don't ask questions of that indelicate nature.
Well, the army doctors used to. They were always inquiring about my love life when I went sick.
Yes, well, medical men have their reasons for asking.
Not when you go sick with flat feet. No, they was fishing. They wanted to know about me and Brunhilde.
Brunhilde?
Where?
Who was Brunhilde?
Oh, wait, I thought for a minute he meant she was here.
Well, have you gone white? Well, nearly white.
Now, come on, tell us about it. Who was this fabulous Brunhilde? Could he just bring some weird names to go out with?
Oh, I've been out with weirder names than that.
Yeah, what was the strangest name you've ever been out with?
Cyril.
Why were the army doctors interested in you and Brunhilde?
It wasn't only the army doctors, it was the whole camp. You see, Brunhilde was this great big ATS bird, and nobody else would go out with her because she had this reputation for brutality.
Here we go.
No, it's the truth. It's the truth, I'm telling you. But I knew how to handle it.
With this whip and chair.
Yeah, but they wanted to know about Brunhilde, you see, because she had this big pin-up of a fella hanging over her bed.
Well, I imagine a lot of ATS girls had pin-up pictures over their beds.
Of Hitler? There's Brunhilde. Hello, my love.
She still remembers him.
This is Brunhilde Mark II. Come and sit down, love, and have a drink. Well, sit down, so will you. All right, I'll have just one.
Just one.
But if you're planning on getting me tipsy so I don't know what I'm doing, you can forget it.
Okay. I have forgotten.
I'll have a brandy and ginger ale.
What got one you invited her?
I tell you what, we're all 50-50. I'll buy the ginger ale. We'll be with thee in a minute, Nora. Once she's got the combination. Cozy.
Oh, great. I wonder how he's getting on with the brandy and ginger ale. I think I'll go and see.
Sort of all his life.
No point in caring if the sun's going to go out.
Well, it might.
How the dickens can the sun go out?
Suppose God went.
Happy birthday to us.
I thought you didn't believe in God.
That's the kind of look I've been having on the chinches lately. I believe in somebody. Somebody who might just think it's funny to go.
Get up, all. Don't be hanging around my campfire. Get up, all.
Is that you, Sid?
Get up, all.
Well, that's a nice attitude to take to three regular customers.
You can take in, can't you, when you're not wanted?
Sid, we've been eating your food for years. We couldn't have had a bigger hint than that.
Don't be ridiculous.
30 bob.
Has to be 30 bob each.
Oh, shut up. We've not been a party to any attempt at bribery.
I tell you what, Sid. For £2 we'll go, and for £3 we'll drag Foggy with us.
I'll stay here.
He's got no flair for commerce.
Oh, yes, but then he's had his trouser meat in cow dung. Now that's bound to unsettle your judgment.
Listen, we're all mates, aren't we?
Bloody
hell. Let us come and get our clothes on. Have ye gone? No, they haven't come.
I'll meet Wally Batty.
The wild Wally Batty.
Howdy, old diver.
Press on.
Rubbish. You're only jealous. Every red-blooded male's got a secret desire to get dressed up like this.
Them three in the trees have had enough. No strike on your guns there. Tex.
Come back, you three. Where do you think you're going? You can't pack it in now. We've got an audience waiting. Hell, what have you done? You made me lose half my pageant. What's the vicar going to say?
Reach for the sky? That's what he's all about, isn't it?
Hello, how nice of you to have come. Are there any more of you?
Me, Big Chief Corporal Signwriter.
good afternoon.
Me, Mrs. Chief Corporal Signwriter.
Good afternoon.
Me, little gaping fly. Tomahawks.
What promises do you do?
Favorite summer wine stars or anything else for that matter, press red, then yellow on your digital satellite remote. Let's know. We're going superstellar with Dick Emery.